To the stadium, course, Prometic is downtown campus. And I'm really excited to see how these projects continue to transform this beautiful city and create opportunity for its residents. The awards today are in communities, as I said, across the state, in different regions of the state. In Cincinnati, there's a variety of projects that are going to continue to revitalize the Over the Rhine neighborhood. In Cleveland, projects like this are going to preserve housing and create new office space. And down in Southeast Ohio, we have a project near New Lexington that's going to use tax credits to remain an industrial facility where the tile company has actually been producing clay architectural tile on site in that building for more than 110 years. And this project is the first historic tax credit for rural New Lexington. And so we're so proud about that. Earlier today, I was down at Van Wert, and they're making their debut as awardees here in the program as well with two projects. Awarded today, a great demonstration of how the commitment to the restoration of these projects and the revitalization and catalytic impact in these communities can really happen. And so I'm grateful for the collaboration that's taking place down in Van Wert. It's really inspiring, quite frankly. And their projects include 11 historic. You know, the applicants worked with our historic pipeline initiative to designate those buildings as historic and set them up to be eligible for this particular program. I'm going to close because there are a lot of people that want to chat and share with you how excited they are about this announcement. I want to thank the Toledo community, Mayor. We are looking forward to the continued positive impact that these buildings are going to have. This building is going to have not only here, but also in historic buildings across the state. And with that, I want to introduce a good friend and a champion, definitely a local government, someone that I have gotten to know over the years, and we've done a lot of really good things together, and it's really great to be back up here in Northwest Ohio and share this moment with him today. So at this point, Mayor Kasich, you're up.
This is a really exciting day for Toledo. It's wonderful to be here with so many friends and community leaders. It's wonderful, as always, to see Whitney. She was a mayor, Mayor Finley, and so just by virtue of having been a mayor, she is someone who knows how to get things done. I think the last time she was up here, I embarrassed her by telling her what a great dancer she is. But in the event some of you weren't here, I will embarrass her again by saying she is certainly the best dancer among mayors, and certainly the best dancer among anyone. And as long as people keep laughing, and next time I'll tell the same story, I suppose. I think everyone who knows me knows what a fan of history I am, especially local history, Toledo history, and it's true. Partly, I suppose, because I think it's fun. I think it's fun that there was a heavyweight championship fight here in Toledo. I think it was fun that of all the banks he robbed, it was the building here in Toledo that still stands that Pretty Boy Floyd held up and actually got convicted for that. And it's kind of fun that Al Capone had a mistress who had an apartment in the Rosemary Hotel, and that building still stands. And there's kind of, for lack of a better phrase, just some of it's just plain fun. But it's more important than that to me. The reason history is important isn't because of how it reminds us of what we were. It's important because it can inspire us on what we can still be. It goes back to the ancient African proverb that who we are is who we were. And if we never forget our past, and if we find ways to honor our past and those people who built our community, then they have never left us, and we'll always be able to draw upon their strength and wisdom when we may need it in modern times. That's why history is important to me. That's really why it's important. Because while Toledoans, we take pride in the fact that we invented the gene and helped put a man on the moon, if that's all it was a wistful reminder of yesteryear, it wouldn't be enough. But when we properly remember history, it can be a signal of what we can achieve together as a community. That's why it matters. And that's why the work that Lydia and her office do, the governor and his team in Columbus, awarding these tax credits is so crucial, because they preserve spaces like this, not just the Jefferson Center in this case during Round 26, but in the past, as we mentioned, Hensville, the headquarters for ProMedica, the old fiberglass tower, the Bannon Park, a project after project after project that allows us to retain the DNA that helped build the city. There's a final benefit also, and that is just the raw economic benefit that can come from preserving places like this. Even if you don't share sort of my romanticized notion of the importance of remembering history, even if you're one of those folks who's only motivated by dollars and cents, well, you'd be happy to know that the building that we're standing in, because of this award today, will receive $45 million in investment. And it will be a place where 400 jobs are housed. And it will be the beginning of a catalyst that I believe can create an entire district from here to perhaps the museum, where Bitwise, the anchor of this building, can help us stoke an entrepreneurial spirit and create a tech corridor that will really reshape Toledo and enable us to tell a story about ourselves nationally that I think we can still tell. So there's a dollar and cents component to this too. It's a wonderful day for Toledo. We've done well over the years getting these tax credits, and I think that's in large part because of the partnerships that we bring to the table. And at the risk of leaving someone out, looking around, I see the Regional Growth Partnership, the Port Authority, and Jobs Ohio, and Connect Toledo, and all of the many partners that were just joined by the councilwoman represents this part of Toledo, and it's Williams, serving the city and the county, have been partners in these efforts as well. When you have that kind of network and those partnerships, good things happen. And today's another example of that. So, on behalf of the city of Toledo, we're thankful to be here today. On a personal level, I wish it was a little hotter in here. But maybe you guys can give me a sweater. Congratulations, everyone. Congratulations to me. This is another step in our forward momentum, and there are more steps to be taken. Thank you.
Good afternoon. I'm Mary Angela Feaster with the State Historic Preservation Office of the Ohio History Connection. We, in partnership with ODSA, work on these rehab projects for all of these optic rounds. Lisa Brunel, who we work with very closely, she and I give a lot of talks around the state, and she says DSA is the dollar sign, and the Ohio History Connection is the building. And so we do all of the reviews for the actual rehab that's going to happen to the buildings. And on behalf of our SHPRO director, Amanda Terrell, I'm very pleased, more pleased than you can possibly know, to join you in this in-person, I am so done with virtual, in-person presentation, although I'm appreciative that it's also live streamed for this Round 26 Optic event. Joining me in person today from the SHPRO office are Kristen Kohlinger, the reviewer for this project, and this amazing building, and Nathan Bevel, who's also on our SHPRO staff, and also a member of our Board of Trustees for the Ohio History Connection, Mr. Bob Lucas, so we're pleased to have all of the Ohio History Connection folks with us. You're all likely tired of hearing by now the comment that this year was one that we don't want to repeat. And while that is definitely true on many levels, there were also a lot of positives. For the State Historic Preservation Office, our work kept right on rolling along. It was made more challenging during the times that we couldn't physically be in our offices with our files and our drawings and our 300 photographs for all of our buildings, but most of all, with each other. We really work collaboratively. But just as historic buildings persevere, so too did we. We never missed a beat or a federal or state deadline. In round 24 or round 25, and thankfully, we were back in person to wrap up round 26, which was incredibly helpful and welcome. I always think that the projects for which I am the reviewer, because I review my own projects in addition to signing off on others, I always feel that my projects deserve to be funded every single time. And that doesn't always happen, but this time, several of my own projects got funded, so I have to give a special shout out to Urbana, and to Van Wert, and to the Newark Arcade, my own projects that received OPTIC funding this round, so yay. And even though I wasn't the reviewer for the Ludovici Tile Company project in Pike Township, Kate Meehan in our office was the reviewer for that one. Ludovici has made amazing tiles for decades and will continue to make amazing tiles for decades thanks to this rehab. So this is a perfect example of meeting standard one, compatible use. So everything our office does is through the Secretary of the Interior Standards for Rehabilitation, and our number one standard is compatible use, and Ludovici is a prime example, a perfect example of that. And I have to give a special nod to the Akron Beacon Journal building that got funded this round, because that is my hometown newspaper. I'm from Maslin, I'm a Maslin girl, but I grew up reading the Akron Beacon Journal. This round, there were also projects funded in Dayton and Xenia and Canton and Springfield and of course Cincinnati and Cleveland, which brings me full circle to this amazing building here in Toledo. The Toledo Central Post Office is a 1911 Jane Knox Taylor designed building listed individually on the National Register of Historic Places. Past interventions on this building have not been overly kind to the interior of this building, but the current rehabilitation project, utilizing both federal and state tax credits, as most of our projects in Ohio do, will help. Kristen is looking forward to continuing to work with the applicant's team. Peter is here from Sandvik, to bring this building back to life, treating its remaining historic features sensitively as historic buildings deserve. So I'm thrilled to be able to congratulate all the recipients, both on their OPTIC awards, but I sincerely congratulate and thank all owners of historic buildings in Ohio who have stuck with their federal and state tax credit projects and stuck with their buildings in the face of unnaturally incredible odds this past year. A sincere thank you, too, for the great team that we work with at ODSA, headed by John Workman. It's an odd week that ODSA's Lisa Brunell is not in contact with our office or we with her. Thanks also to our partners in the federal program, the National Park Service, and our NPS reviewer, Raluca Philemon. And please remember, owners, the easiest way to receive approval at the end of the day is to do the projects for which you received approval for. We're here to answer any questions, and now that we're regularly, physically back in our offices, we are absolutely here to help you. So here's hoping for an even more normal year to come, and congratulations again, and thank you so much for including the Ohio History Connection in this wonderful day. Thank you.
The good news is I'm the last speaker, so that's the good thing. Thanks for all being here today. I want to just take a minute and thank the mayor, thank Lydia and her team for being here today and the staff for me, The mayor and all the great work his team that you know, he's done over the last few years, City Councilwoman Denise Williams as well here. A lot of leaders from, you know, the folks who kind of get up every day and kind of make our community better, and a lot of folks represented as well. The Preservation Office, SCIFO, and all the folks who do the work. And then some of our neighbor partners that were here today, people that we've worked with, and they're good neighbors, so we know we're moving into a great neighborhood. You know, a couple years ago, we had Jeff in Canada that spoke at an event with him. And it was about 10 years ago. And about halfway through his talk, he stopped and kind of looked at people in the Toledo audience, and he said, I just have one bit of advice. No one is coming to save you. And that was true. And what's really happened over the last decade, because of all of you, are Toledoans have worked together to save themselves. And it's a variety of projects, it's a variety of collaboration, it's a variety of people doing different things in different places. And when you look back at it, it's like one big puzzle. And pieces have fallen into place. Last week was a topping ceremony for the convention center. And we ran through everything that happened in the last 5 years. And it's $1 billion of projects. And so when you begin to look at what's happened in the last 5 years, you have to be really good. You have to feel proud to be from Toledo, you have to be proud to be from Northwest Ohio. And what's interesting about it is when you look at the next 5 years, you should be equally as excited. And the number of projects that are underway, the different types of projects that are underway are really exciting. And in a lot of ways, this is another big piece of the puzzle, because this represents, you know, a lot of different good things. We talked about this building being built in 1911 by James Knox Taylor, who did hundreds of federal buildings across our country. And at one point, there was a decision made to actually tear this building down. People back and read about it. Luckily, that never happened. And today, as we stand here with support from the state and the federal government and a lot of partners, next year, in 2023, early first quarter, this will be a major innovation hub, and as the mayor said, really set us on a different path. We have great partners. The Prevent Innovation Group will move here. You all know about Bitwise. We even talked to Bitwise. Bitwise will create 500 tech jobs within 3 years. They will employ hundreds of people, and they will do work across the United States, and that's a starting point. Jumpstart has been here for a number of years, providing support for entrepreneurs, startup businesses. It will be in this building, and we're in discussions with two new innovation leaders, one that works in the senior space, and one from another state that, because of the things going on, are in discussion about relocating here, in addition to a number of companies that really are interested in working together in a very innovative environment, and I think really see the potential of Toledo not only being a great manufacturing community, a place where things get made, but also a great center of innovation and tech. And I think that's going to be the next part of the puzzle. So again, thank you all for being here. You can rush in your cars now with your air conditioning. Take a look at the pictures here a little bit. This was a magnificent building in its day. And when we're here in 2023, you're going to see that that was magnificent. So again, thank you for all being here today.